It's time, and not for the first time, to give thanks for the pledge, committed as we are to free speech. That's because there's been yet another assault on that fundamental right. This time, the offender is a dopey advertising boss who lost his job, first suspended, then he resigned, for the crime of speaking his mind. Now, while his crass comments clearly belong to another age, just when did this Stalinist imposition of groupthink creep in? Some people say some smart things. Some people say some dumb things. Do they all have to be pursued on each and every occasion like some modern-day McCarthyite witch hunt? After all, if we all got into trouble every time we said or did anything stupid, none of us here would still be in work.
Nick, I'm really confused with this one. I was sitting there thinking, if I had a CEO working for me, and he made a comment like that, would I immediately suspend him or sack him?
I'm going to come back to you, because let's just, for viewers who don't remember, let's just remind the viewers exactly what he said. Here we are. This is Kevin Roberts, the former executive chairman for Saatchi & Saatchi. Their ambition is not a vertical ambition, it's this intrinsic circular ambition to be happy. He's talking about women, of course. So they say, we're not judging ourselves by those standards that you idiotic dinosaur-like men judge yourself by. He goes on, I'm just not worried about, that's the lack of women in leadership roles, because they're very happy, they're very successful and doing great work. James, you run a lot of companies, would he be gone for that?
It's a difficult one, Nick. I would probably
say dopey things.
Yeah,
as I
that's what
right
I'm saying. I would probably call him in.
I would call him in, and
I would reprimand him, tell him that that is not acceptable as an organisation. He has a responsible position, you know, both for the company and society, and you know we would not tolerate that. But after 20 years, would I force him to resign over it? It's his opinion. You know, I'm not saying it's right.
The problem that you've got, because I agree with a lot of what you said, is this wasn't a conversation that he was having at home with his friend.
No.
This was in a professional publication that he was being interviewed to represent Saatchi & Saatchi. So he was speaking on behalf of Saatchi & Saatchi. So after 20 years in a role in a company, one would expect that you understand the culture and the values.
Especially at Saatchi & Saatchi.
Exactly. So one would expect that as a senior exec,
we
you understand the culture and values.
Sure.
Yes, but what I'm saying is we do get things wrong, and I put my foot in it all the time.
Yeah.
But when you are interviewed and and you're representing the brand, this is not a casual thing. He was representing the brand. You must, and I argued this about the Love Island girl when I was saying about losing her title, not conforming to the brand values. When you're at a professional stage and you are interviewed in a professional capacity, you must always represent the values of your employer.
I've got a different question.
You've been strangely, quite frighteningly quiet.
Can we come on to in a moment, which I suspect is the more interesting part of this debate, is what he was actually saying about women and us having lovely circular ambitions and no desire to get to the top.
Men have got vertical ambitions. It's so Freudian.
Let me come back to that. I've got a question to you. It's the same area as Nick was questioning here, is I would be suddenly very worried if I was his boss. I was surprised that he got suspended because I read the whole interview and I thought, you know, pretty short-sighted,
nice guy,
misogynist, worked with many of them. Know many of them very well, fondly. But what I would say is...
Does she look at you?
are you of the mindset, or would you be worried that he had impeded women's ascension in a company? Would you be concerned that his view of women being happy where they were had impacted when he had chosen women for a job?
You know, I was thinking about that a lot, and I thought...
That's the legal area.
But the interesting thing is, the industry that he represents actually is highly dominated by very successful women.
It's not at the top. 35%
of the top. Creative director is only about 15% of women.
But if you look around, I'm not just saying media, in terms of advertising, marketing,
the question. He specifically said, women are happy here, milling around in the middle bit, what they call the bottleneck, so they never really quite get up to the top. He's a top guy. He will have been responsible for appointing all sorts of people throughout this long career that he'd had. My first concern, if I was his boss, obviously I would never get to the top because I'm happy swimming around here in a circular ambition pool with Rachel and Michelle here. If I was at the top, I would think, hang on a minute, who's he interviewed lately? And did he just think they were happy where they were?
I would be very disappointed. I'd be extremely disappointed that... as somebody in a position of responsibility at the top, that he would have such a warped view. I would find that strange because there are people
what's
in his own.
View? Wait a minute, before
just I understand.
No, but the fact that he thinks that women have got no ambition, that they're going to be
but
just.
Some of them don't. No, some of them just like are happy.
No,
but
before we move point. On to.
No, but hang
what
on, let me just finish the question. So, yeah, okay. So I don't think. You know, I would be very disappointed because actually. As the chief executive at Organise It, which is the size of
Science. But what would disappointed
me? But hang on, I would be, yeah, I'd be disappointed to the extent that he should not. He should be much more balanced because that's what you expect somebody in that position.
But we're getting away from the group thing. This is the debate, not necessarily the gender impact. It's why this man has resigned, been suspended, whatever.
Can
it is simply for saying something stupid.
Provocative.
Yes, I like to
you get please welcome
do.
To the pledge.
Fearless. What if Sheryl Sandberg had said, sometimes women are happy where they are?
She said something stupid.
Sorry,
as
just
well.
Reminds me no, Sheryl Sandberg is chief operating officer of Facebook.
What if a woman had said this?
Wait,
no, but would she have had to resign if she had said,
most
in my
not.
Experience of running a
most
business,
certainly
a lot
not.
Of, a third of women. It, in the group are happy where they are. They don't want to rise to the top because they've got parents and they've got kids and they're happy where they are. Would she have taken early retirement?
Do you know what? Many women have said such things
exactly.
when I was researching
and
this and they haven't been subject to those rules and they should be. It should be equal. If you're going to say, basically my issue with this is we need to stop treating women like some weird homogenous blob. There are unambitious women and there are ambitious women, just like the same in male
so
groups.
We've got to stop treating them like a minority who needs special treatment.
Yeah, exactly. But this is to come back to your point, Nick, which
yeah,
was the
which,
question.
Which is about
which,
the group thing,
which
as opposed to
the
gender
thing.
Fight, which I specifically... Yeah. I agree, it's mad, he shouldn't have said it.
Could we get that on tape? seriously.
I think he was right. He was well within his rights to say it.
But to answer,
wasn't he?
Hang on a minute.
Probably
no, but
not his job,
sorry, I don't think in that job you can say something like that. No. I really don't.
But all the bosses say it should say he's dopey.
But a female boss
should have said, "I'm sorry."
Should be subject to that as well.
Isn't it? That's the way to do.
But would a woman have had to resign for saying that? No. So in fact, he is the victim of discrimination.
But he's gone against the values.
He's gone against the values of the business. In a public interview.
And that's what I'd have a problem with.
Yeah, but
definitely.
It's not only that he's gone against them, it's that that's what he thinks.
We're getting to a point. What Nick's saying is, and I can't believe how much agreement there is here,
if
we're getting to a point
that you and I do, it's going to become impossible.
We're getting to a point where censorship is basically the order of the day. Because I tell you what I'm more concerned about is. I'm more concerned that he holds those views in that job.
Correct.
Like
wouldn't
James
you rather
is
know
saying,
that he does?
I'd rather know.
Thank you. So you'd rather know.
Yes, but you'd rather know that with a conversation. You can't. It was a public interview where he's representing your brand. When you've done work to make yourself a progressive and inclusive employer...
Do you know how boring these interviews would be? We'd never find anything out if they're media-trained within an inch of their lives.
Yeah, but it's not about being media-trained. It's about, if you represent your brand... He's paid, I would imagine, or was paid, a stack of money by his employer to do the best job for that organisation. He needs to understand the culture and the values of that business. Either does, or he doesn't.
Well, he's thought like
Michelle,
and if he doesn't...
I'm sure his boss had a conversation with him. And say, you need to do the right thing and step down. Mm. So there is no question that that is exactly what happened because he put the company into disrepute and has caused damage, and I think it happened really quickly.
Yeah. Or he could use this moment, and the company could possibly use this moment to say, you know what, I'm an idiot. I don't understand female ambition. Let's work with this and let's do
but
something.
He did kind of come out and he did give an incredible apology and he apologised.
He needs his payoff.
And let's tell the viewers what the group has said. This is a statement from the Publicis Group. Publicis Group Chairman and CEO Maurice Levy addressed a statement internally to all Publicis Group employees to reiterate the group's no-tolerance policy towards behaviour or commentary counter to the spirit of Publicis Group and its celebration of difference as captured in the motto, Vive la différence. So that's how they dealt with it. My concern, just coming back to the point with you and I, is if you look at past examples, Peter Alice, do you remember the golf commentator, forced to apologise in a sexism row at the Open? His crime was because he suggested that the winner, Zach Johnson's wife, might want to spend the money on a new kitchen. And a veteran commentator like Peter, there's just a sense of humour failure now. People, as I say, say dopey things. Why do we need this witch? Or bad jokes.
Really bad.
People make bad jokes. People make bad jokes.
I know, I listen to you a lot.
I know, so we don't have to have full frank apologies because you make a bad joke. It just happens. Move on. Is what